Hey everyone, welcome back to the Protector series. In this video, I am going to show you how to use the import statement in our test script and also how to use the code suggestions in our VS Code. In our previous script, we have used this const driver through which we are able to get the code suggestions, and when I do mouse over on any function, I'm able to read the documentation as well, right? Now, this is perfectly fine, nothing wrong about it, but whenever I used to write any function, then I have to call this driver dot, right? So we are going to get rid of this driver dot and we are going to use the import statement. I'm going to remove this line and then I'm going to get rid of this driver dot, right? So let me select this word and copy and paste. And here I'm going to replace that without any value, right? So that means driver dot is going to disappear now. Now let me uncomment this, and if I go to my terminal and I have to navigate to my folder, and if I run this script now, this is going to give us error because we already saw this. We cannot use the import statement in our JavaScript file. Syntax error, we cannot use the import statement. To fix this, I'm going to install two dependencies. The first one is Babel preset and another one is Babel register. Now Babel preset has been deprecated. You can see that here it's mentioned it has been deprecated, but we are using this for our local environment, I can say, so probably we can use that, nothing wrong about it. So I'm just going to copy the syntax and I'm going to paste it in my terminal. So let me clear and paste. And here I'm going to give the enter. Now this is going to install some libraries for us. Similarly, we have to install another one, which is Babel register. So let me copy and paste. Okay, now here in my script, I can see that whenever I mouse around browser and dot get, I'm able to get rid the documentation. But in terms of ID or the send keys or the by, we are not getting any suggestions because we have imported the browser, but not the element or the ID or the by, right? So here, what we have to do is you have to import the element and the by as well. So just click on element and give control space. It will ask you to do the import. So I'm going to import that. Similarly, I'm going to import the by as well. So whatever the functions you are going to use, we have to use the import statement. Similarly for the protector as well. So here I'm just going to give the control space and click on enter. It will do the import statement for you. Now here we can read all the documentation, right? So here you can see that browser element by and this protector also has been imported. Now, even still, if I run this, so let me show you. It is not going to work because we have to do some configuration in our config file. As expected, we got this syntax error, right? So let me go to my config file, and here we have to use the recur statement for our Babel. Okay, now again I'm going to run this. Okay, so our script started to execute it. That means we are able to use the import statement in our JavaScript code, right? So this is how you have to use the import statement to get the code suggestion in VS Code. In previous video, we have seen using the require, we are able to get the documentation, right? But for each and every word, we have to write driver dot. Instead of that, we can use the import statement, which is going to give us all the code suggestion. So let me write your test case and let me show you. So here I'm just going to write a dummy test. So some test, and here within the callback function, I'm going to use the browser and the element object, right? So here I can use the browser dot, and here you can see I can get all the method suggestions or function suggestions in our VS Code, right? Similarly, not for only browser, we can also use for the element. So here I can say by dot, and it is going to give all the locators suggestions as well. Okay, so let's quickly recap. So you have to add these two dependencies in your package.json, and also in your config.js you have to use this require statement. That's it. You can use the import statement in your test script. The advantage of this is you will obviously get the code suggestions, and also you can read the documentation. So that's it from my side. I hope you have learned something new and you have enjoyed the video. If so, please consider giving a like and subscribe to my channel. See you in the next one very soon.